Well, I would start from saying that I'm very happy to shed light on what vision the Polish government has on the future of Europe, because it does not always correspond with the vision of the public. But the current Polish government is obviously feels uneasy about Britain's departure from the EU. I think you have similar sentiments in Ireland as well. This is because both the current Conservative Party in Britain and the Polish Law and Justice Party, they sit together in the European Parliament. They also have similar views on the future of Europe. So, for example, the Polish government is not necessarily in favor of deeper EU integration, feels uneasy about the notion of ever closer union, would like to see a stronger position and stronger voice of member states in the EU decision-making process. So, as you can imagine, this is very similar to the vision that David Cameron had when he tried to renegotiate Britain's membership in the EU, and he failed. I think I would start from saying that the Polish society, the public, is still very pro-European. So more than 80% of the Polish public supports Poland's membership in the EU. Having said this, I think that if you ask further questions and if you dig deeper and ask polls about their feelings about certain issues like migration, refugee crisis, and perhaps Eurozone integration, you would get different answers. And it seems to me that this is because issues like refugee crisis or Eurozone integration, they touch upon on the very issue of sovereignty. Yeah? And this is where the Polish public is more split. And a similar case is with the ongoing investigation of the European Commission in Poland and its rule of law framework. Again, even though perhaps not everyone is happy about what the Polish government has been doing domestically and is not happy about the domestic reforms, judicial reforms, well, if you ask Poles, they would be very much split on whether the Commission should be interfering into something that many of them actually see as a domestic issue. Yeah, I think I would like to come back for a second to Brexit, because obviously Britain's departure from the EU poses a challenge for Poland and for the current government, mainly because indeed the UK has been one of the biggest allies. And if you look actually back, the UK supported Poland's membership both in the EU and in NATO, and hand in hand also Poland and the UK promoted a deeper, a sort of deepening of the single market. So indeed, Poland will have to reach out for other allies, and of course, security issues. This is something that Poland has relied on UK and a partnership with the UK. So if you look, for example, into the ongoing negotiations on the future relationship between the UK and the EU27, I can see that the Polish government will be trying to push for a very robust and ambitious relationship between the EU27 and the UK in issues like foreign policy, defense policy, and perhaps also justice and home affairs. But having said this, I think it's important to stress that this government, perhaps unlike the former government, has invested a lot in intergovernmental really partnership. The problem is that it has also antagonized many European partners with backtracking on the rule of law. Yeah? So it will be very difficult, for example, for Poland to build coalitions ahead of, for example, multi-annual financial framework discussions. And as you know, this is the moment where every sort of relations with every single member state are important. Yeah, so we'll see how it goes.